they are trying to appear like that trusted party. So then without knowing, you may be losing your information. So can I know, are you all familiar with phishing or is it very new to you? So if
no, we are familiar. Yeah, we did it in the first module.
All right, okay. So then, okay, I will not go into detail because I was planning to do some demonstrations with tools. I think it is not necessary. Then you have some idea what is phishing means.
No, but you can still demonstrate. It's not a problem.
All right, okay. So let's see then. Another one is Niffin attack. So Niffin attacks, what people is trying to do, they are just monitoring network using different tools, maybe Wireshark or some tool like that. So then they can just monitor what's going, what are the data packets, and simply they can see the username and password. Like after we get the password and username, so you know, simply we can reach some into some server and take out data. All right. That's another popular way of attacking. Then, some other common terms like we use is malware is a common term for.
Hello, Prasanna.
Yes.
Yes, please. Can you kindly go through the sniffing again, please?
Yes. Okay.
All right.
So this one, do you want me to go through a video or a
no? The sniffing. I need more explanation of that.
All right. Okay. Got it. Like, so what we do, right? Just think. We can in the network we can install tools like Wireshark, right? So then we can monitor network data packets. So what is going on there? Right, so we can use some tools to create repositories, data repositories first, and after that these data repositories, so we can access, and after that we can analyze, like, so login and get let's say website, so get method related details or post method related details, so you can see actually the data packets moving from one system to another system to the network. So then when someone read it, so then he can easily see what is the username and what is the password. Got it. What I'm trying to mention, or else I can run some demo YouTube clip and show you how they are doing it. Okay, shall we run a some demo and see? So then maybe much clear to you.
Yeah, that would be fine.
Hello. Yes, I think I'm audible to everyone, right?
Okay, no problem.
Right. So let me run some demo with. Let me share this with again with sounds. We are not enough to cut.
Is two most common unencrypted.
So can you hear this one?
Just yes, I'm hearing. Yeah, I'm hearing. Yeah, it's
protocols,
okay.
FTP and HTTP. Now, what unencrypted protocols basically mean? They exchange or transfer the data without encrypting in plain text by default. So it makes them extremely vulnerable to the sniffing attacks. So anyone who intercepts traffic or data can easily see sensitive information like usernames, passwords, or other relevant data in plain text. And it is incredibly easy with efficient tools like Wireshark. FTP is used for accessing computers or servers remotely. So in order to access servers remotely, you need to log in first, right? That's where they become vulnerable to the sniffing attacks. And HTTP, as you already know, is used for sharing the information through web pages. But unlike HTTPS, HTTP does not encrypt the data. So when someone enters login details or form data into HTTP websites, the information becomes easy to intercept and can be seen in plain text. There are many vulnerable protocols who exchange the information in plain text. I'll give you a list of other text-based protocols that you need to be careful from at the end of this tutorial. So in this tutorial, I will not only teach you how to analyze and extract information from HTTP and FTP, also how to defend against sniffing attacks. Now start the Wireshark. I'm using Wireshark on Windows 10. In Kali Linux, write sudo Wireshark to start the Wireshark. All right. So guys, if you are new to Wireshark, then watch my previous video on Wireshark. It is specifically created for absolute beginners. Now we are going to start with HTML login details sniffing. So what is basically going to happen when you or someone else on your network enters the login details into the HTTP website, then Wireshark is going to capture everything, including the login details in plain text. So if you want your Wireshark to capture traffic from other devices on your network, then you have to ensure that your promiscuous mode is enabled. So go to the capture, click on options. Down here, check this button, enable promiscuous mode, all right, on all the interfaces. Now select your interface. To demonstrate you guys, I'm going to log in into the HTTP website. Then we will analyze the traffic. So let me open my web browser. Now this is the login page. Now let me enter the login details, Dimalu, username and password, root. Now log in. It really doesn't matter. So I'm going to click don't save. Now back to our Wireshark. So I'm going to stop the session. As you can see guys, Wireshark has captured around 2000 packets, but we are specifically looking for HTTP packets. So in your filter bar, write HTTP, hit enter. Now as you can see, it has basically narrowed traffic down to the HTTP packets. But here also we are specifically looking for the form data that user submitted to the website. So we have a separate filter for that. Write http.request.method equal to, within double quotes, write get. There are two methods used for submitting form data from pages like login to the server. One is get and another is post. I'll tell you the difference. So for now, press enter or click on here. As you can see, it did make get requests. And down here, you can see the login page was requested with get request as well, but there is no form data submitted with get request here. As you can see, that is because 99% times form data is submitted by post method. Get method basically includes form data in URL, so it becomes visible to everyone when it sends data to the server. So it is barely used for submitting form data unless a developer is clueless. So here also post method is used for submitting the form data. Post method basically embeds data in the body of request message, not in URL. So it does not reveal anything. So write post and press enter. Now, as you can see guys, we have packet with form data here. So click on the packet which says user info application form URL encoded. So this is the form data. So click on the packet and down here click on HTML form URL encoded. And as you can see guys, we have the exact username and password. This is the username that I entered and this is the password. Well, defending sniffing attacks like HTTP is very easy. Unless you use something like Internet Explorer, all the modern web browsers warn you before entering sensitive information in HTTP websites. So keep your web browser updated before logging into any website. Check whether website is using HTTPS or not. If website is using HTTPS, then your data is safe because HTTPS encrypts the data before it leaves your computer. All right.
Returning to work
with ClickUp.
Right. I think you got an idea.
Yes. Yeah.
What is sniffing is, right?
So yeah. Okay.
You don't want to run the entire thing. I think I will send you the links. So then, Leslie, you can go through the entire thing and see the rest of the thing. I just want to give you an idea.